So let's go ahead and open this thing. I'm going to see if I need to turn up the lights more. Oh, yeah. We're going to be working on unboxing. We're going to set up the teleprompter, do a simple setup. We're going to connect it to our Stream Deck. And we're also going to do a little bit of demos with shouting out people. And yeah, we'll see how it goes. And that could show you what it looks like from my end. So y'all don't really, you know, you're not going to really see it from this end, from this camera. So you know what? I got another face cam. So we good. We good. All right. I need some hypes in the chat. If y'all really want to see this, throw some emotes in there. And yeah, I'm going to go grab this box. So can y'all hear me still? You can hear me still? Okay, good, good, good. So let me put that out of frame. So this is the outer box that it comes in. Inside, we can see what this actual box. I'm also going to start recording. All right, man, you know, so one of the biggest things I'm really excited for this is that I'm going to keep more eye contact towards the camera and I'll be able to look at chat at the same time. So I won't be able like need to get do one of these numbers where I'm looking at chat in this monitor and then responding to y'all or even just responding over in this direction. So I think it's going to help boost more intimacy with the community and anything that I have to recite, it's going to be so much easier with this Elgato prompter, baby. This camera looks smooth. So this camera that we're using right now is the regular face cam. It comes with a whole bunch of other things when you're using the hub. Let me know if it's choppy because it's choppy on this thing. You see that? It chopped a little, right? I think it's because I'm using a lot. Here, let me see. There you go. Okay. So we're good now. We're good. Ever since I first heard about this, I was so excited. I was like, I gotta figure out a way to get it. They did not give this to every single Elgato partner. I'll let you know that. Elgato wanted to make sure that they're gonna give it to creators that not only were going to promote it, but also create content with it to show the capability of it just to make it a lot easier for the public to decide whether or not they need it. Because I know they want it, right? Y'all want one of these, but do y'all really need to have something like this? It might become a need. I'm gonna use this box as like a trash bag. Look at this box. So this is the prompter. You can see it looks like, so that little plate on the bottom is actually the monitor. This right here is the monitor. And this is the little shroud that you put the lens in and you could use pretty much any camera. This one has a plate that's made just for the Facecam Pro. But there's a lot of people who are savvy at 3D printing that can essentially make face plates for any of their camera lenses or webcams or whatever camera device that you use. In the meantime, they gave us a universal shroud that is already included in the package. So it'll just be a quick setup for when you're wanting to use any other camera that doesn't have like the automatic face plate on there. And I'll show y'all. Yes, it's called the prompter. Because it doesn't just do teleprompting. It does so much more. All right, built-in 9-inch display. Yes, 9 inches. Everybody thinks it's small, but it's a lot. You know it's a lot, chat. Interchangeable backplate system. A large field of view. So you're not gonna actually get this little vignette that you would see on other teleprompters. Single USB cable for the power and the data. And it's compatible with most DSLRs, mirrorless cameras, camcorders, and webcams. Flexible mounting. So they got mounting. There's so much mounting points on there. And then you can also put like the Elgato, the Keylight Mini on it. And then it has another slot to put it on if you have like a shotgun mic or something like that. What else is on there? Oh, this right here. If you don't want to use this as a teleprompter, chat, you can use this as another monitor. It's essentially another monitor that you could use that goes over your face cam. So if you're at like a work meeting and the football game is on or a UFC fight is going on, you want to at least look like you're paying attention, you know, to your work, you're in your meeting, right? But really, we all know what you're doing. You're watching the game, you're watching the fight, and this is one way that you could do that. I'm going to show you. So with the packaging, accessibility-wise, I would recommend some type of blade that you would use to open things. A lot of the boxes, I would like to talk with Elgato on just, you know, creating a better shipping, a packaging experience and an unboxing experience for people with motor disabilities. So Elgato, if you want to get in touch with me, I was one of the people that helped influence Microsoft and Xbox to change their packaging, starting with the Xbox adaptive controller. So let's go ahead and take a look at this. So I'm gonna, there's two tabs I'm gonna cut. Oh, Dusk, what's up? You need my dog, great for the box shredding. I need something a little bit neater, even though your dog is probably very effective at doing that. So, this tap right here, it's put in there fairly well. For those with motor disabilities and use scissors, and you have ways to grip your scissors, right? You can either put your blade in the slot and then do one of these numbers. Boom. See, Chad, this is not your regular unboxing, all right? I'm gonna put this on, you know, on the internet as a YouTube video later so y'all can see it. But for those that are live, y'all can see the full experience. All right. Screwed if you need to return something. That's funny, Dusk. So you got three panels that you got to open up. Ooh, it says get connected right here. So the box is pretty in there, pretty snug. So let me, I'm trying to open it without like breaking stuff, like ripping the box, like trying to keep the integrity of the box. If I hold the top. Because I'm going to try to do this without my teeth, right? Okay, I got one out. And then I'll put that in this box. And then we'll do the same thing with this one. Thankfully, it's not like twisty tied like 30 times, right? You've dislocated, you just dislocate your fingers undoing, oh my gosh. I've seen plastic wrapping that has perfect edges. All you have to do is rip it apart. Oh, perforated edges, not perfect. Well, they are perfect. So this is starting, like when I untie it now, it's starting to move around, so. I'm sorry, occupational therapist. This is the reality. This is the reality of it. All right. Look at this nice, thick cable. And if you look at it, USB-C, it's angled. Angled USB-C. I don't know why my shit's lagging. Spicy, what's up? All right, we're just gonna keep on going anyways. All right, boom, we got the cable. Nice, nice long cable, 6-foot cable. So, we'll go ahead and put this right here. And then I'm going to show you this real quick, the step up rings. So if you have like a DSLR camera, all right, I love this low, I love the low profile mic arm is, man, so good. So when you open it, you have a whole bunch of different rings for the different lenses that you have. And you know these rings are made of aluminum or some type of metal. These are not rings that are made of plastic. So CNC'd high quality rings for your camera lenses to make it fit on your prompter. I'm going to close this. Eventually, I will probably be using something like that. All right, for now, we're gonna go put it in this box. Okay. The universal backplate, no, the universal shroud backplate. DSLR mirrorless backplate. Two things in here. Opens up from the side. Yo, thanks for the lurk, pizza. Hope you're doing good. While we open this, who's going to TwitchCon? And if you are y'all ready? I still need a pack. I already know what I'm gonna wear anyways. Let's dump it out. This right here, this is plastic. This DSLR mirrorless camera mounting plate. So if you have one of those cameras, this will be the one that you would use. And then this bad boy, this is the shroud that essentially seals off any light. And then right here, where my hand is where you're gonna put the camera. So then it'll look something like that, or like right there, but it'll be closer. Y'all won't see it. Also, you're gonna need this. Weep, 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 weep. Okay, ready for me to grab the prompter? All right, I'm gonna just take this part out. Actually, I'm just gonna dump it on my lap. Big dumpy. Hopefully it doesn't fall apart like my life. This is what it comes in. So it looks like it's in there fairly secure. So you just kind of dig your fingers in here. Everything is wrapped in a nice little fabric type of covering. So this right here is a camera here. Okay. Look at that nice touch right here. Right there, look at that. I meant this will make a clean setup. Yeah, it's gonna be pretty nice. All right. These are right there. I turned them down the music a lot. I'm not looking to get monetized I don't get monetized anyways in my YouTube channel. Right now, I don't care. I'm here just to give y'all the good information. Remember, 9-inch display. I'm gonna go ahead and undress it. All right. Dang, okay. Oh, I already put my finger on the thing. So we're gonna take a look at the front. See, you could see this panel, the glass panel. Right here is the Facecam Pro faceplate. And then right here is the monitor. So what we'll do, oh, on the back, you see these screws? That's how you take off the faceplates. It's fairly light. Now this is another piece you'll need. Now, if anybody's like concerned on, say you have a heavy camera, how is it gonna affect the weight of it? Well, they suggest that you use a stronger mounting, like a mounting source that will hold the weight of the camera that you're using. So here, this is meant to put onto this, and this is where your camera moves back and forth. Just mount your camera here. Yeah, your tiny arm for your camera will not hold it. All right, I think we got the main pieces to setting up this camera. So what I'm gonna do, as a person that I like, I always go to the instructions on the quick setup guide. Now, I'm gonna go ahead and do a little bit of looking at it. Universal backplate shroud. So I'm gonna switch over the shroud and I'm gonna show you how that works. Okay, all right. So what's going to happen is we're gonna take off the Elgato face cam on this one, and then we're gonna mount it onto this, and then we connect everything together. It is ready to be mounted. So everything, it wants you to mount it not directly onto the monitor, but onto multiple mounting points depending on the type of configuration in section one. Oops. So it's very important to have your own mounting solution for this, which a lot of people already have. So this goes on the back, and this mounts over onto the back of this. Right here, like that. Okay. So I'm gonna remove this sticker. I'm gonna need to use the scissors. ASMR instruction reading. You're not a typical guy. You actually read the instructions. Look, there's a reason why there's instructions. So might as well read them without causing any confusion, right? Okay, so we are going to switch the cameras. The first thing you do is trash the instructions. There was also teams in the military, but who reads those? I mean, I did. I wasn't an expert in anything, so technical manuals are the way to go. All right, I am going to, because there's a way, I'm gonna connect both things. So I'm gonna grab this camera right here, I'm gonna unplug it, and then attach it to this. Get over here. All right. So what you want to do with this, you want to go ahead and take this part off. It'll I'm gonna unscrew it. All right, so I got this mounting plate. So what I'm gonna try to do is actually use this to hold up the prompter, which I feel is actually going to work. Now, mounting the camera, you wanna mount it on the part that has the little cool grate. You see these little grates right here? That's where you wanna mount it, is on this piece, right there. So, I'm gonna go ahead and flip this bad boy over. Align it, and then hand tighten it, all right? Let's get down tonight. Boom. And you can tell it's for the Facecam Pro. It has that label right there. And what we're gonna do, we're gonna get this shroud and plop it in. So you wanna plop it in from the bottom. This is where you want to insert this part first, right here. So that part goes in first, plops right in there, nice and easy. You get the mounting screw one, boom. I'm just hand tightening it. Now, chat, be careful when you're using this because it's loose. You don't want to drop it inside because it could scratch the teleprompter. So be careful. Right there, see? Take your time, let the bolt set in there. There you go. Look at that. Now, grab this bad boy. Oh. It actually goes on this way because you want it to telescope into the prompter. Now, what we're gonna do is there's this mounting screw right here, and there is a mount right here. That's where we're gonna match that screw, and that'll help figure out where the camera needs to be vertically. I'm gonna loosen up the camera and try to bring it as forward as possible. The more forward you bring the camera, the better. You don't want the lens to hit the teleprompter, the glass. So if this came with like a little tool, I think it would help for those who have less dexterity that need to tighten these things. All right. Now I want to carefully get this screw. Placed right on there. All right. So to make it easier, I'm gonna flip it this way. And then, of course. Yo, what up, Mario? Okie dokie, Mike, you have to get off and stream. Yo, have a good one, Vinny. Thanks for stopping by. So, all right. Aligning this isn't as tricky when you have it facing towards you, right? right here. So this just has the regular face cam, the Elgato face cam on here. And there's a little bit of that weight, right? There we go. All right, for my purposes, I'm making it easier for me. It's a lot easier if I have stuff on my lap. So that's what we're gonna do. Put this on my lap right here. What up, queen? And then I can hold it a lot easier and then try to get that in there. So right now, this is probably the most difficult screw. Oh, we got success. Found where we want the height is, and so I'm going to try to hand tighten it. Ah! All right. So now I'm going to tighten this piece. Can you help me with tightening something? Can you hand tighten this?
It is.
Okay. I wanna make sure. Can you hand tighten that for me? Now, while you hand tighten this, can you ensure that it stays facing down? And just don't put your hand on the, don't put your finger on the lens. Okay. Cool. Think so. Sometimes you just gotta ask for help, chat. And thankfully I got my dad here to help. And so I'm gonna see what I can do the rest myself. No stupid questions are in here. You aren't asking any stupid questions. Does this sit on top of the PC screen or is it a stand job? So, I would recommend using another mounting solution to instead of this right here. But in the meantime, especially what we want to do for demoing and just experimental purposes, is to see what the capability of this right here, if it is feasible, because the weight of this, it could be too much. So we're just going to try it out, chat. We're just going to try it out. Honestly, this is probably something that Elgato is going to be like, nah, I don't think you should have done that, but you know what? We need to figure these things out to make sure that yes, you definitely need that mounting solution. So what's nice about this cable, it's angled and it plugs in right here. And this is the screen. And then now I need to get this and plug it in the back. All right. Everything's plugged in. Now the fun part. So, I'll say this right now. This is not... prompter into my USB hub. Hello, hello, hello. Hello, hello, hello. Check 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2. All right. I might have accidentally hit the mute button. All right, let me go ahead and plug this part in. Yo, everybody at Elgato, the people are like, what are you doing? Look, I can see at the top of my monitor. I can see all of it. The only thing about these braided cables is that they're just so, sometimes they're too thick, and it's just hard to manipulate them with low dexterous hands. That's why it's really good to have representation when you have your product design. Can a user with low dexterous hands be able to put this together? Do you even care? So you can see me right here. And then right here is going to be the teleprompter, so you can see. So what we're going to do, so what do you use for this prompter, right? How do you activate this thing? So once we get everything set up, I'm going to go back into the instructions. I'm going to look at where I need to go into. So double check that the ball head is fully tightened. Oh, okay. That's for the mounting solution. Elgato software. Camera hub necessary for display link drivers. Features prompter, free teleprompting software, free Twitch chat reading software, display link, presenter. So, it's not in any of these, right? So how do we get that? So intuitively, without looking at the instructions, you would think that something would pop up onto the monitor and says, so the software, it wants us to download Camera Hub for necessary display link drivers. For Android, download the display link driver from the Play Store. So display link driver. So let's go and do that. I'm gonna go here. Mighty get a second camera for the Lego builds. Hey, let's go. Okay, so I'm going to put this over here. And then we'll put it up here, right? And then we're gonna go Elgato, right? And then I'm gonna just type in display link. And then it's popped up so right here on the Google. So you have Thunderbolt 3 dock and dual support. So that's the first thing. There's Screen Link and Screen Link Pro. Display port displays. So that wouldn't be it. I'm just wanting to check to see how like seamless it would be to get to that, right? And this is like without having any knowledge or doing anything. I want to go through the steps that anybody else would want be probably most likely go through, right? I know that I need to bring the face cam forward some more because the more forward you bring out here, the less you're going to have anything protrude on the outside. But let's go in Elgato and then type in prompter. See, I don't know if Elgato wants me to do this like super seamlessly and smooth and have all the knowledge for it, but I wanted to go through an average user experience of unboxing it, setting it up, looking at the pieces, and seeing how well the instructions navigate you and guide you to setting this thing up. Why is it under shopping? Well, you get a bundle though. So I'm just gonna go to the Elgato website. I'll go here, I'll go back to Elgato. Prompter. And so what you could do is go down, usually you go down to the bottom of this and it shows, you know, this is like a nice little presentation, what everything looks like, which is really cool. I'm just scrolling down some more. It shows you the different faceplates that you could use and asks if your camera's compatible. So here, this is the software. Manage your script chat. This is all under the hub. And so what I need to do is download the Camera Hub prompter. So in order to do that, there's downloads right here. So I click downloads, right? Because I already have this, right? So do I need to check for updates? Ah, there's a new update, chat, 1.8. That gives you the prompter support. Make sure you have your stuff updated, chat. All right, boom, next, install. If it requires us to restart, I'm gonna try to see if it works without restarting it. Allow changes, yes. It's gonna reload prompter again. Drink some more of my F3. All right, we're gonna go to finish. Initializing video engine. Now, we're gonna go ahead and make sure that this is enabled. I'm gonna go back here, select it, and then go select this to camera 2, which is the face cam. And then what I do is I go back to webcam here, deactivate, activate it. There we go. All right, now, as you can see, there is an option right here. So usually you would have the camera and then effects. Now you have prompter. And it looks like the prompter isn't plugged in to a correct USB hub. So let me go ahead and fix that. Yo, Jackie, thank you. Chat, do you see this? Do you see this up here? We have a third monitor, baby. All right, let me go ahead and turn off the music. I'm actually gonna lower it down. Now it's literally a third monitor that you can use. Now, when you look out here, it says output. It should have your Elgato prompter on here. Then you could change the brightness, right? Now, content. So you have chat, you have text, and you have display. So what I wanna do is go ahead and click chat and then see what happens here. Now, it looks like what I need to do is add a Twitch channel, like the quad add. Prompter is now displaying your stream chat so you can read and respond to viewers without taking your eye off the camera. Go ahead and personalize your text for maximum readability, adjusting your font, brightness, and more. Okay, now let's see if it's doing that. So you could change your stuff right here. I'm gonna switch it out here. And then I'm gonna do this again.
Hey subscriber, I see you.
Yo, Rez, thank you so much for the gifted sub to Hoptown. All right, so what we need to do just from looking at it, so it has a display, right? So you could change the display on here. But now what's happening is that there is no, okay. Oh, this is like a thing. It says, ready to roll the camera, video script or talking points, camera hub, prompter gives you full control of your delivery here in text mode. There's this stuff where it's similar, camera placed in text to enter as you go. You can add emojis if you want to. Once the text is entered, it's easier to read and you can change the font, the size and text colors, fine tune the margins, ideal positioning. There's more prompter controls, which I want to do, use the Stream Deck to even use. So I'm gonna have to get the prompter plug in for that. Okay, so we had it on. Now what we need to do is figure why we're not, Power is plugged in and there is power. So let's go ahead and see what we can do to troubleshoot this. I'll hop on your town. Hey, yo, Queen Jackie. Automatic scrolling. Okay. So let's figure out this troubleshooting, chat. Let's figure this out together. We got the new updates. I'm going to click this to see if it'll have another update. Okay. All the way up to date. Now, clicking that, it brings it on and then it turns off. So what I want to do is I'm going to actually exit the camera hub, go back into it, let it initialize again, go back to here, and now it's working. It's connecting to the chat. And let's see what it does. Evening. What's up, Mario? How you doing? Mike! All right, cool. It looks like everything is working really well. Now I can adjust the font, chat. We want to make the font different. I am a big fan of Arial because it's nice and bold. So you want to see this on the screen? Yo. Oh, Comic Sans. Yo, Queen Jackie, you like Comic Sans? That's so funny. Yo, Phasma with the hypes. Yo, how's it going? Okay, this is actually really sick. Wait, it made Comic Sans when you type it out? No, it wasn't in Comic Sans. Roboto for the win. Yeah, that's funny. So it looks like it's working really well, chat. I mean, I could just focus on this so I could read the chat and everything. I want to go back and look to see like how my eyes, you know, are when I'm like reading the chat. I'm just blind then? No, it's okay. It's okay, Queen Jackie. I can actually see if I can make it into Comic Sans. There you go. I just for Queen Jackie, I made it into Comic Sans just for you. And as you can see, it has this. Now, what I want to do is I want to check out to see what it's like to do shoutouts. So let's go ahead and do shoutouts. Like I can have this up for now. And what I need to do is I'm probably going to do another tutorial on just exactly what type of plugins and the way that I use the Stream Deck and integrate it with the prompter. Oh, the Stream Elements thing where it's okay. You can't even see the camera now. It's amazing as fuck. Yeah. So I can see like there's like a blue line right there where it's at. So as a weird question, if you write out a script, would it read off there too? Like if you were filming an intro, you want me to show you? Here's a little example. And we're going to go ahead and you could adjust the scroll speed by a lot. I'm going to put it on 8%. Ready to roll the camera? Whether it's a video script or talking points, Camera Hub and Prompter gives you full control of your delivery. I would probably not, you know, change that, you know, and I probably, you know, when I read, I don't sometimes necessarily read what's actually in the text right there. Now, this is on 8%. So what I can do, I'm going to increase it to, so this is on 25% right now. It says, here in text mode, Prompter automatically mirrors anything you enter onto its screen. This way you can stay on script while maintaining natural eye contact with your audience. Yo, what's up, BDs? How you doing? So while I have this on here, as you can see, it doesn't show like the chat or anything like that, but we have another solution. So as you can see on like the scroll speed, this is at 25%. If you have like a lot of dialogue, you might want to slow it down. Or if you don't have that much dialogue, what you want to do is just speed it up. So with its familiar interface, Camera Hub makes it easy to organize your text, paste in text, or enter as you go. Add emojis, bullet points, and line breaks. Separate content into readable chapters. And then you can like go ahead and like, you know, let it scroll. It depends if you're doing like some type of filming, which I would do just kind of like, just kind of break and then just do a jump cut and then go to this part. Once your text is entered, add formatting to make it easier to read. Change your font and your size. Adjust the background and text colors. Fine-tune margins for ideal positioning and much more. So this is just a big example of what the scripted stuff is. So what you could do, I'm going to go ahead and stop this part. If you look over on, oh, you already could see right here where my mouse is. I'm going to go ahead and pause it, right? So what it does is you could do this into different chapters, right? And you can click to whatever chapter you want to recite, right? Now, let's go ahead and go to text. And now what it does, it looks like it takes a little bit for it to connect. And then once it's connected, it'll probably just start going. So what we're going to go ahead and do is we're going to give in the breaking news. And the breaking Mike news today is Mike has a new toy. All right, let's go ahead and do a shout out. I'm going to shout out Phasmopolitan. All right. So it's going to have like a whole bunch of script. So what I need to do is adjust the size on here, right? And so what I'll do is I could change the margin also. And then what I need to do is, I wonder if I could pause the chat. So basically so I could just look right here. It says, meet Phasmopolitan, the horror variety streamer who's got a knack for making your spine tingle. They're a Dead by Daylight killer main, but don't let that scare you away. With their inclusive LGBTIA+ and non-binary streamer tags, they've built a community where everyone can enjoy a good fright. Their recent return to streaming was marked with some Next Fest demos after a thrilling Dead by Daylight session. Got questions? They're all about AMA. So tune in if you dare. So that's just a really cool example on how you could use this and how you can adjust everything. I'm going to go back to Ariel. Sorry. Actually, it looks more edgy and maybe a little bit less easier to read. But yeah, this is the prompter chat. Now, you want to see something else cool? So not only is this a prompter and a chat reader, stuff like that, right? Let's go to display. Let's go to display. Hello? So it says prompter can act as another computer screen. You can view any app website while maintaining eye contact with your audience. Just drag Windows over to prompter. Oh, so what I need to do is let's go here and let me go to a YouTube video and I'm going to do the Elgato prompter video. And then what I'm going to do is this is the prompter trailer. I'm going to stop it and I'm going to just grab this window and drag Windows over to the prompter. Do I put it in here? Do I literally just put it in here? Or do I... Because when I had it on display, right? Here, let me see if I can... So let's go and figure it out before finding the solution. We could try to troubleshoot the solution ourselves. So the biggest thing I believe, let's see, if we don't see the prompter, let's see, what can we do, chat? We have other options right here on the display, right? Content on what the content is, the appearance, and then you have the scrolling, right? So we don't need the scrolling and we just don't need that. And then we just, all right, chat. So the monitor where it's at is to the right, right? Watch this. See where the mouse is right here? But the thing is that is not displaying it. So interesting. Okay. So see where you can see the mouse on here? It shows that this is the display. So let's see what we can do. Because it's not showing it. Like when I drag it over here, it doesn't show it. So what I need to do is I'm going to actually go into Windows. I'm going to right click on the screen. I'm going to go to display settings. And then right here under the display settings, what I want to do is kind of put that on top, right? And I'm going to apply it. Oh, it's on the top. See, look, chat. Now I can click this and I can watch this while, you know, we're just having a chat, chilling out, whatever. Another thing which you can do, say if you wanted to like watch this at the same time, right? So since I'm in Windows 11, I can go ahead and just put that over here. And then now I'm gonna get Twitch chat right here, right? But since the Twitch chat is too small, so what I wanna do is I wanna go ahead and Go to chat settings. Oh, my chat. Pop out chat. And then move it up here, right? And now I have the chat. I can watch. I can read the chat right here. See whatever y'all want. And I can increase the size of the chat right here. And then I could also be watching stuff. You know, like BD says, oh, nice. You know, this is so cool. I can just maintain eye contact. I could be watching YouTube videos. I could be having a conversation with y'all at the same time. I got multiple chats on here. This guy is so cool. Yo, what up, Trey? We got Trey Kane in the chat. So this is the power, the capability, and you could see the potential on content creation for live production, for even offline stuff. If you want to go onto a Zoom call, you can still have stuff right here, right? You could still have your chat and you can still maintain eye contact and you can watch stuff, whatever you want. And then if you use a Stream Deck and you have your Wavelink, you can have it to where you can only still hear your own music and then change the levels of the music or the chat that you're in. You can do all that stuff. Yes, this is perfect for Zoom. How big is this screen? It's 9 whole inches, Trey. 9 whole inches. So now what we can do too, so this is the display mode, right? Now we could go to text mode. This might be a third screen option. I think it's an excellent third screen option. It doesn't go into the vertical sense. So if you're wanting to like solely dedicate this to like Twitch chat. Yo, Reza with the crazy how many things you could use it for. Exactly. See, I didn't even have to like take my eyes off in order to like read the Twitch chat or anything. Probably doesn't work well with people that have a bad prescription. Right. But so say if you want this right here and I just didn't want to do this, right? And I want to go back into teleprompt mode or chat mode. I'm going to go back into the chat beta, right? Now it's connecting. So one of the things that I found is then when you switch the type right here on your content, you need to go right here to the Patellasaur. What up, Patellasaur? How's it going, chat? We got a raid, baby. All right, let's. You know what? I'm gonna see. We'll see. Patellasaur's on here. I'm gonna go ahead and actually, Lord, I think I had it to where you can shout out people now. Lord, go ahead and try to shout out Patellasaur because I have it with mods and VIPs. But then, as you can see, though, you can't. For now, you can't stop the scroll, like the chat scroll. Which then you would want to use a Stream Deck integration to control your chat, your Twitch chat. So that's what we have. Can't stop the scroll. Here, I'm going to go ahead and give Patellasaur. Oh my gosh. Oh, you got to add him. You got to add it. Here you go. I got you. No need to do it. All right. So, and thanks again, BDs, for showing me Frosty. So as you can see, it does this, you know, the shout out stuff, but with Frosty and one of the big things I want to use for the teleprompter, while we introduce, you know, and talk about, you know, Patellasaur, right? Looks like they were playing Assassin's Creed Mirage. I'm going to actually be playing with Patellasaur at TwitchCon via the internet on Fortnite from 10 to 12 Saturday Pacific time. So as this is like going, what's going to happen is Frosty should be calculating or getting me a nice little summary of a Patellasaur. And if they aren't, we have a problem, Frosty. We have a problem if you're not going to be working. So there are a little bit of, you know, a couple nuances on just like getting used to how everything's set up, making it make sure that your bots are working in order to have a smooth production. And then, you know, once you kind of like know how to troubleshoot these little small nuances, I think your production in your stream, at least a live production, will go a lot more smoothly. So we're going to go ahead and do this again and see if it actually... shouts out Patellasaur. Yo, what up, Dr. Fectus? How you doing? How's it going? See, and then the other thing is like, because the reason why you want to stop chat, say if you have like a really chatty community, you know, you want to be able to stop, you know, the scroll and all that stuff. Florida's amazing. Florida's really awesome. You definitely need to get one of these, Phasmo. Yo, I 100% think so too. Yo, Patellasaur, what's up? Hey, Beaties, are you still in here? Have you ever ran into an issue where Frosty isn't doing what they're kind of made to do? I'll take an order for one. Chat, if you want to go ahead and take a get the order, use this link right here. This is my own personal link for Elgato. As of now, I don't get paid for any of the products that get purchased, but the more people that click this link in order to get to Elgato to look at the products that they have, it helps me. What's Frosty? Frosty is a AI. It's an AI that's supposed to come up with a summary of anybody that I shout out. So chat, we're just gonna keep on shouting out Patellasaur.
Yeah, check him out. And hit that follow.
Until it actually works. And then also let me check in the chat to see if there's an issue with it. Is that you saying it? It's also, oh, that, hey, you got it. We just did a shout out. You need to go check them out and hit that follow. Yes, that is me. All right. Oh, okay. They're not in it. That's why. All right. That's why it's not on here. Okay. Let me go to Frosty Tools. Boom. Let's go to about Frosty Tools. And then I'm going to go to this. And then I'm going to the dashboard to see if it's connected. It says my channel is connected. Mod, I'm going to go ahead and see if they were unmodded for some reason. Sometimes that can be an issue. So always make sure. It says that they're already a moderator of this channel. I'm going to see what happens here. So what happens is, okay, it's working now. So here's an example. It says, Resin is your go-to streamer for all things Apex Legends. With the side of Overwatch, Halo, Rocket League, and Fall Guys, they're not just playing games, they're grinding for them. From Platinum to Diamond Rings, and if you think you're decent, join in. They host tournaments and might even carry you to victory. Carry me to victory a lot. So come hang out, play some weird community games, and just enjoy the pew 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 action. Just don't let them smack your mama. That's Rez. Now we're gonna get Patellasaur. We're gonna get you that proper one, Patellasaur. So if anybody is interested on using the Frosty Tool, oh, here we go, chat. Meet Patellasaur, the voice command virtuoso of Twitch. Milan, a variety streamer with Dushin MD, yo, I apologize that I cannot pronounce that person's name, but Patellasaur has mastered gaming with voice commands and adaptive tech. From conquering Battle Pass to navigating Starfield, their streams are a symphony of spoken strategy. They even dabble in design work on stream, and their last known adventure, Assassin's Creed Mirage, all controlled by voice. For this innovative gamer who's making accessibility look like child's play, at anyone who thought games needed hands. Oh, and oh, laughing at anyone who thought games needed hands. So go check out Patellasaur chat. So basically, this is what the capabilities of the prompter. This is the capabilities of what the prompter can do. So, and then Frosty Tools, what I'm gonna do is here is the website, go here, copy, go here. If anybody is interested in using it, it's just as easy as modding them and then connecting your channel to it. And then it creates these different scripts, these prompts. You do shout outs, and it's really good at gathering the information based on each individual streamer. So, describe me better than I can myself. I know exactly. You know, it kind of brings like a little wholesome, like warmth, you know what I mean? For just realizing like, wow, this is, I actually do this stuff. So, but yeah, chat, this is the unboxing, the setup, the demo. I'm going to go ahead and, you know, I'm going to mount this actually not onto, you know, my monitor, and actually have a mount for it. And I'm going to adjust the camera to bring it a little bit closer so then you won't see this bottom part and I don't have to crop my my webcam. And then we also did the setup and the demo just to show you what it's like to even use any of this stuff. Have it as a third display, have it used as an actual teleprompter, and then just, you know, having as this, your Twitch chat. So I think it's a really great tool. And, you know, for those who stream on Kick, you know, you just pop out your chat and just put it on there when you're using it as a display. So there is a lot of versatility to using this. Hey, yo, Mingo. I mean, Mario. Mario, I got you. Mario was on the fence on whether or not he wanted to get this. So, oh, you're last playing Sunken Land. Nice. So as a last prompt, Mario Zig, the PC gaming aficionado, invites you to join their digital adventures. From driving big rigs in Euro Truck Sim 2 and American Truck Sim, to exploring open worlds like Ghost Recon Wildlands, they've got a game for every mood. Recently, they've been diving deep into Sunken Land, unearthing ship secrets, and even taking a swim. They're always up for new game suggestions and community-based games. So hop on board. Just maybe skip the bus ride. just maybe skip the next bus ride. So really, it's all limited to how well you can read, as you can see. Does it do a random write-up? It's not, I wouldn't say random. It takes the information from your streams and collects the data, and then it formulates a prompt for shouting out and describing, you know, each streamer. So, all right, chat. I'm going to go ahead and get going. I need to go ahead and get some dinner, and I need to pack for TwitchCon. Thanks, everybody, for hanging out. I appreciate it. And we're going to get this set up even more fine-tuned. And I hope this either persuades you to either get this, you know, and considering on getting one of the prompters that just released today, or, you know, just it helps solidify the fact that whether you want to add this right now to your production. I feel like it can immensely help you, especially for scripted stuff like on YouTube. And I think the other really cool thing is just having it as a display, and then also having your Zoom call on there, and then also having, like, you know, any other thing that you want, because it's a whole display. So